Okay, so our next speaker is Alexis Delevingier from Lille. He's going to talk about three-dimensional homophobic TFT.
Yes, thank you. So this is a joint work with Vladimir Poranev. So the plan of my talk will be the following. So I will first give a general definition of HPFTs, homotopic quantum theories. Next, I will consider the case of dimension 1, and then the case of dimension 2, and finally the case of dimension 3. Okay. So what is the HQFT design is the following. We want to define, construct TQFT for manifolds with extra structure. So, and so you can think of an extra structure given by a map to a classified space. So more generally, we want to define TQFT for manifold with maps to a given topological point. Space. So E. So here for this node, X will be a fixed point. Okay. So now I will define a category. So I do not use I should call it n of x for n. So what are the objects of this category? So an object are pairs N F where N is the pointed flow oriented N minus 1 manifold. Dimension n minus 1 and f the map from n to x which is point. And here when I say that n is pointed, I mean that each connected component of n is pointed. But what are morphisms of these categories? So a morphism from an object n1, f1 to an object n2, f2, let's say, is an equivalent class of such pair, let's say n. What is M? M is N topomorphism from the first manifold N1 to the second one. So what does it mean? This means that I recall that M is an oriented N manifold whose boundary is homomorphic to the opposite of N1 and N2. I know what is H. H is a non-homotopy class. Max from M to X such that on the boundary it is a Prescott map F prime. So I can give a picture of this. Which restrict to F1 and F2 on the boundary. So now I said equivalent classes. What I mean here, we have M H will be equivalent to H prime if there exists an orientation preserving default. So let's say F on M to M prime such that. So, what can we do? H prime F is homotopic to H relative to the boundary. So that's the morphism of the category. And this way we obtain that H cog N of X is a symmetric monoidal category. So I need to give you the composition in this category. So what is composition? Composition is just the doing. So if I have two morphisms, so M1, the M, N1 to N2 and the second one, so I lose that. I use the two properties along the common component. And here I take the union of H and H1. This is the composition in the category. So what is the tensor product? It's just the disjoint union and the unit object. This category is just the empty set view. So I view the empty set as a closed manifold in any dimension. Okay. So we have a symmetric monoidal.
You have pointed maps from manifold, and in H there is no any way to keep track of these pointed.
H is not pointed. So on the boundary it will be pointed because F1 and F2 are.
In cobertism, you don't need like this.
No, there is no
L something.
No.
So why do you need pointed maps?
Sorry?
So then why do you need pointed maps?
On the boundary. You will see, for example, you see. So this is the structure of the category. Now we can define the notion of HQFT. So by the n-dimensional, so homotopy quantum field theory, so HQFT, so we target the space X. This c'est donc là.
Let's go.
Donc, en 10 catégories. Say retrospective. So in practice, what does it mean? That means so there's the following data. So for each object, we have a vector space. For each morphism, we have a linear map. And also, so this is a functor. Monoidal means that we have canonic web isomorphism. Will be there's compatibility with composition and tensor product, and also the symmetry must be preserved by this data. Okay, so make some remarks. Let's see the case where X is a point. In this case, the category H code is just the category, usual category of Cobordville, and so we get the usual notion of equals. Okay. So the second remark is that when you have, if you take the and morphisms, Cobordism with where the boundary is empty. So what do you get? You get a linear map on the space associated to the empty set, which is K. Orientation préservée, anomorphique, isomorphism of N, which are compatible with F, the map F to the local. So, likewise, we can define some modular group of space with a map to X, and we obtain a finite dimensional representation of this map.
Okay. Is that pretty restrictive or not?
Excuse me?
To assume that F was zero, is that restrictive or not? Is it restrictive? Is that no? I was wondering how restrictive it was. To assume that F is zero, it seems pretty restrictive.
Is it only homeotopic or do you want to be
commutative? So once the target will be a spherical, it's so if X is an aspherical commutative of homeomorphism, this will be the same thing up to isotope. But in general, so maybe we can see an example in any dimension. This example is called cohomological quantum field example. What is the definition of this space? So it's a one dimensional vector space, just k. Okay. So now I need to explain how to define the linear map associated to a morphism.
theta over t over tau, but I don't see an independence on theta in this definition.
Theta is augmented by this cocycle. Now, if I take a morphism between two objects, so what can we do? So we take a We take V in M of M such that, so V, whatever V is A2 minus A1, and B is the fundamental class of M. N-dimensional H squared. Maybe I can make a remark. If the boundary of M is empty, so what is, so we know that we have a numerical invariable H and it is defined as well. You can pull back the class theta. And you evaluate the fundamental class. Okay, so this is an example in any dimension, and this example are called homological homotopy. Okay. So let's see what happens in dimension one. Object of the category. So zero dimensional manifold is a point, is oriented, and we have a pointed map to S. So here there is a unique pointed map to X.
Do you assume that X is connected?
No. Not here. But
X is not connected, then it's not connected.
Yeah, you can assume if you want X to be connected, but so this, we know that maps to finite dimensional vector space. So there is another object with opposite orientation. So we know by the general remark that it maps to the U. So now, what are cobordies? Morphine in this category. So we have, let's say, morphine from plus to plus, like this. We have here the pointed map to X. And we have H. So this data is the same thing. So we have a homotopy class of map, which sends of a path. passing as G in an element of fundamental group of X. This is G. And so this gives you our field. And the axiom of HQFT gives you that this is you a finite dimensional representation of the fundamental group of X. So for one dimension HQFT, what we will have that one dimensional HQFT we start with X are the same thing as finite dimensional representation of a one of X, and you will note this is the same thing as finite dimensional that vector bundle over X. So in some sense, you can think of n-dimensional HQFT to be higher dimensional generalization of flat vector bundle. So next, the game will be to construct example of HQFTs. Construct example of issues. So from now I will assume that the target space X is aspherical. So this means that this is a KG1 space. Okay, so this is the first.
Excuse me, you have 2 plus 2x and minus 2x. Why you are considering maps only of pluses?
Yes, the other are evaluation correlation. You can.
But so, then you have maybe 2 copies of fundamental groups. So one for pluses, one for minuses.
No, because they are related with. They are dual. This is a general remark.
So you can.
In fact, this category.
Representation
is object is a category of H cobordism as dual and dual are preserved. This is a general fact. You only need to know the value on the plus, and we immediately deduce the value of the negative, the opposite orientation. So now we assume, to simplify, that the target space X is aspherical, so this is a KG1 space, and a consequence of this is that the space, the vector space associated to an object, only depends on the homotopy class of F. So from now we are in this situation.
Okay.
So now what happens in the two-dimensional case. this and equal to. So I will draw that two-dimensional usual TQFTs are in correspondence, random correspondence with so-called commutative Frobenius algebra.
Are you saying that it doesn't depend on n?
No, no. It depends on n.
Because it says only depends on homotopy class of f and f.
F.
So it depends also on f.
Yeah, but n is part of the data of f. N is a source.
Okay. So then, even if it's not a spherical, doesn't it just depend on homotopy class of f?
No, from the definition.
You're saying if you have a cylinder, it does not necessarily induce the identity on the vector space?
No, because here the map, here you have boundary components, so there is it is pointed, so this gives you in x an element of the fundamental group, which is not necessarily one. So the cylinder is not always the identity. If here is one, if this this loop is mapped to one, is null homotopic, then it's okay, it will be the identity.
So here you mean free homotopy class as opposed to base homotopy class? Is that what you mean?
No, yes.
So up to isomorphism, I mean, homotopy of F doesn't change the isomorphism class of the dimension of that vector space.
Yeah. You can say this way. So if you have an isotopy between two F, this gives you an isomorphism and everything is natural. So you can identify them in a natural way. Okay. So here, what we have, so this result of Troyev, I think it's around 2000, that two-dimensional HQFTs with targets the space page one space are in one-one correspondence with the called crust Frobenius GL. Okay, so maybe I can quickly explain what are these objects. So these are G-graded algebras.
Sorry, G is an arbitrary group?
Yeah, you fix an arbitrary group, not necessarily finite. Algebra. So endowed with the so-called non-degenerate pairing, that's Frobenius algebra. And cross means We have group over field. Such which sends the component AH in the AGH minus 1. Okay. And this must satisfy some actions. And the action which replaces commutativity is the following.
So, sorry, phi is an automorphism of G of A.
So, if automorphism of A. Okay. And so, if I take A in A of G and B A of H. So AB, so this belongs to AG, AH, so this is AGH. And you can now, if you take BA, you belong to HG. So you have to replace a commutative isomorphism by this one, EG of B. This makes sense to ask them to work. Okay, this is one order action which replaces commutativity. Okay, so maybe I could give an example of this. If I take theta, I say, two cohomology class of X. So X is a KG1, so this is something of H2 G1. Okay? So you can represent theta HQFT, and so this will correspond to what valid algebra A. This is a group algebra AG. What is the product? So you quiz the product of the group with the two cosine. Correspond to the cohomological HQFT. Okay. So let's now speak about the three-dimensional case. Then you can consider the center Gehr, shot in that Z center is modular. And then, starting from such a C, you can consider two CQFTs, the variable of CQFTs and the reshaping variable. It will be defined with the center, and so we draw with the YF, and there is a, that this TQFT are isomorphic, and there is another proof from Balsam and Kirillov in the case of the field is characteristics. Okay, so that's a general setting for TQFTs, and basically the same thing works for HQFTs. Explain how does this work. In the case of the coordinates, no boundary. So we can that that the vertices of T are sent to the baseboard of the target box. So now, the coloring of T, coloring of the triangulation. So if you take an edge in, so the vertices are sent to the baseboard F. So H of E is a loop in X, so you can take the multiple class. So you have an element of G. So the column of T is a function from edges. Simple object, and such that C of T is in the composer. This is the object. And now we can use, we can modify the trivial state sum to define this number. The color of the edges, and now you can consider the two-five part. The product of our tetrahedron. So each tetrahedron has six edges. And so you can construct from these six edges. So you have six colors. And so you can construct from the semi-simplicity the CG symbol. So you take the product. In general, these are operators you need to contract. So it is this. And so you have the normalization. The dimension of the row component minus number of vertices. And this gives you the numerical value of H, which takes M as component. Okay. So this is first the generalization of this. Maybe I can quickly say that if V is a modular diffusion category. So we can construct the homotopical version of the Rashid Tekin for F. So we have a three dimensional HFT. We target the H1. Frobenius, cross-Frobenius algebra, you need some kind of winding, so you need an action of G by tensor automorphism of the category C, which replaces the thing, and you need the winding. So you have G of Y, you color the binding like this, and using this and the search representation, you construct this restricted version. Okay, so I have no time to explain, but in the previous talk, as far as I understood, Fiji was the identity. Okay, so now I have maybe 1 minute. Okay. So to finish the story, okay, we need to use some center. So what? No, so let me know the spherical free fission category. So by a result of building Gelaghi Michi trick in the ready center, which is the center of C relatively to the C1 component, the neutral component, is a G ready. In this sense. And so, and what we prove here is that this center, so in the case of the dimension of C1 is non-zero and the power the algebraically curve, so we prove that NG of C is a modular diffusion. And the Toyer derivation is isomorphic to the version of this Cradet center. The semi-simplicity is used, you write this, but you have a sum of coloring.
Yeah.
And you color by with simple objects. And so you need some finitely many simple objects, synthesis. And you need some relation how to decompose the tensor product of simple objects into a simple one to prove that everything works.
Yeah, I understand that you use
in the proof. You can, there is techniques to get rid of semi-simplicity. So, this is a work with my students, Michael Lelouch. So, now if you do not assume that C is semi-simple, but still finite in some sense. So basically, there is some specific object here called the point of the category. You assume that it exists. And so you can define. You can define a TQFT from code 3 to. To see to some, let's say, the symmetric, you can define, starting with C, some symmetric subcategory of C, and you have a symmetric monoidal functor. And one, the category is semi-simple. This category is vector spaces. But in general, it is not vector space. But still, this exists. And you can adapt this technique to the HQ this time. But this is quite complicated to define. So semi-simplicity is just you want to construct a fiber functor. So the existence of a fiber functor here is equivalent to the semi-simplicity of C. And so if you want to have TKPT with target in vector space, in some sense, you need a semi-simplicity.
Okay, so then I'll very few questions. I would suggest to relegate more questions to the coffee break, and we meet again in half an hour.